Today is Thoughtful Thursday. My name is JJ Wickings, and today we're going to be talking about setting boundaries with digital stuff, specifically with your phone right now. I've heard people being really critical of millennials, my generation, about how addicted to our phones we are, which is really frustrating because phones are a really good way to keep in contact. I know people from across the globe because of the internet, and it's cool that that's a thing now. You can answer almost any question within a minute. Usually, when I was 10, you had to bike to the library and look it up, and what if your library didn't have a book on that subject? Then you were a SOL. But now we have our phones and we can just look that shit up right then and there, which is amazing and so cool. I just can't get over how cool that is that we can look stuff like that up. You can, like, be really creative with your phone. Like, all the apps that we have these days. I'm filming this with my phone. I've filmed every video I've ever made with my phone. So I find it really unfair when people are just like, oh, phones are just time wasters. They're just used to ignore us, blah, blah, blah. Because I don't think that's always the case. However, I do think that I personally have a problem where I ignore people for my phone. I look at my Facebook feed, I scroll through the whole thing, I put my phone down, and then half a second later I'm looking at my phone again. I don't need to do that. There's nothing new and I know it. I do it anyways. And I've heard a lot of people complain about having that problem because you feel bad for it and you don't want to your friends to think that, oh, my phone's more important than you, but because it's so ingrained in us, it's hard to break the habit. Without saying that phones are evil inherently or the internet's evil inherently, because I do not believe that is the case, I wanted to talk about setting boundaries because you can still use things like Facebook and Instagram and YouTube in a very healthy way without letting it take over your entire life. So the first thing I recommend is allowing notifications only for like really important things, like actual phone calls. Who knew? Direct messages to you, not just likes or comments on your photos, but actual messages to you, because most likely, comments can wait until you actually open the app. Another thing that I've done in the past, and I have to do it every so often because I get bad about it and I know it, is deleting the apps that I have the hardest time avoiding. I've deleted Facebook more than once, I've deleted Twitter more than once, I've deleted Instagram more than once, and I've definitely deleted Snapchat more than once. All of those apps are really good time wasters. Some of them more so than others, but if you delete the app, it makes it harder to get back in and to get sucked into that time vortex again. So if you have a problem with a specific app, delete it for a little bit. Another thing that I would recommend, and this is going to improve your sleep quality and your like mental health, is not allowing your cell phone in the bedroom. And I'm real bad about this because I like to watch TV while I'm falling asleep. I've been meaning to hang up a TV in my room so I don't have to have my phone in my room. Do your best to not keep your phone in your room because then as soon as you wake up, you're going to be scrolling through that newsfeed and it's going to waste you half an hour because it did to me this morning. So if that's something you have a specific problem with, do your best to fix it. And then my last tip is to just not always have your phone on your person. Sometimes people will have their phones on their person when they don't really need to. Like, if I'm on a date with my husband, I don't really need to have my phone with me at the table. I try to leave my phone in the car when I'm on a date with my husband because there's usually nothing so urgent that it can't wait half an hour till I'm done at that restaurant. He's really important to me and I like to make sure that he knows that, and a really good way to demonstrate that is to not ignore him for my phone. There are good things about phones and there are bad things about phones. You just have to keep an eye on yourself and give yourself checks to make sure that you're not letting it take over your life And phones can take over your life. Reading too much can take over your life. I definitely was that kid in elementary school. TV, video games. There are lots of things that can be the exact same way, and a lot of these tips will work for those things as well. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you enjoyed this video, there will be more tomorrow, and the day after that, and the day after that, for the foreseeable future. So I will see you all later. Peace out, friendos.